Hey there, football final fans. I'm Melissa Miller, and with me is Jamie Lutz and Jill Logson. We are the brains behind your high school football final show.
We are reaching out to you today to offer you a chance to be our Week 10 guest selector. How, you ask? All you need to do is post a picture on Facebook showing us your high school football final school spirit using the hashtag 2018 HSFF Spirit, which stands for High School Football Final Spirit.
All photos will need to be posted on Facebook with this hashtag by Sunday, October 21st. We will review all the submissions and announce the winner on our Week 9 High School Football Finals show, which will air on October 24th.
All we ask is for the selected guests to be available to film our Week 10 High School Football Finals show on Tuesday, October 30th at 4 o'clock in the Bucyrus office of Ms. McMiller & Company.
We are looking forward to seeing how creative you can get in showing off your school spirit.
Good luck!
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. It is week number 6 of High School Football Final. I'm Josh Stallings of WQEL and WVCO Radio with Roger Miller of Mizzick Miller, Brad Seibert of Plymouth Insurance, Dean Williams of Dean's Trophy House, and former defensive coordinator of Upper Sandusky for 19 seasons, Coach Dale Piaja. High School Football Final is brought to you by Mizzick Miller, Plymouth Insurance, and Dean's Trophy House, as well as WQEL and WVCO Radio. Let's get rolling with week number 1.
Okay, I'm going to start off with Riverdale's Alec Loveridge. Unfortunately for Riverdale, they got beat by Liberty Benton 34-7, not because of Alec, because Alec had a pretty daggone good game. Alec, quarterback, had 5 completions on 9 attempts for 31 yards. He caught 2 passes for 90 yards. I don't know. Throws it to himself again.
Maybe.
I don't know. In addition, he had 18 carries for 108 yards rushing. He had 1 touchdown, and then on defense, he had 1 tackle behind the line of scrimmage. So my first sticker is going to go to Alec Loveridge of Riverdale.
Well done, Roger.
Awesome.
It's my first time. For Mohawk this week, in their win against Colonel Crawford 14-7, we selected Kobe Stillberger at middle linebacker. He had 15 tackles, 2 solos, and 1 TFL. And also on the other side of the ball, on the offensive side of the ball, he plays guard, and he graded out great for his coaches, and the entire offense put together 340 yards. So great game, fantastic job, and good luck in the rest of the season, Kobe.
I'm going to stay with that same game, Dale. I'm going to go with the Crawford Mohawk game. I'm going to go to the other side, Jordan Fenner. Although in a losing cause, 14-7, to stay with Mohawk, I think that we couldn't overlook, although it's not the best of stats that we've had all year, but Jordan definitely had to be a player that night. He had 5 receptions, 85 yards, 1 touchdown, the only touchdown for Crawford. Just one more and they would have been in. This could have still been going on. So, good job, Crawford, and Jordan Fenner. Congratulations.
All right, let's go up to Seneca East this week. Put this kid in a video game. Blaine Schwartzmiller, 300 yards on 29 carries, 3 touchdowns, other side of the ball, 6 tackles, 5 solo, and 2 TFL. So congratulations to Blaine Schwartzmiller. Big win against Winford this week, and Seneca East trying to keep things alive in the N10. So.
What an awesome game.
And he ran over everybody.
I as well am going to put my guy in a video game. Bucyrus' human highlight reel, Harley Robinson, got the game started early for the Redmen with a pick 6 from about 30 yards out to really get things rolling for them. He's also caught 3 passes for 87 yards and carried the football 8 times for 144 yards, adding 3 touchdowns through that, all in 1 half of football. Harley wasn't even on the field in the second half, so to finish with the combined yardage that he did, up over 220 yards, is it's a pretty good day. So, Harley, my helmet sticker is going to go to you. Great game.
Untouchable in the open field on Friday.
Absolutely, he was.
So back to me. Buckeye Central, Bucyrus. Unfortunately, Buckeye Central came out on the wrong end of this one, but Tommy Phillips plays guard and defensive end, had a fantastic game on the defensive side of the ball. He had six tackles, six solos also, and two tackles for losses and one sack. Kid's only a sophomore. The coach always loves this kid. He says he works really hard and puts forth a big effort. And congratulations, Tommy. So you get the sticker for this week.
It's a definite bright spot for Buckeye Central football.
Yep.
Well, I don't think there's any debate on this one, player of the week. Seneca East Plain, Schwartzmiller, he was a man amongst boys, phenomenal football player. He will get our player of the week and a plaque from Dean's Trophy House. So congratulations, Blaine Schwartzmiller.
All right. So all the helmet sticker winners this week, as well as player of the week, can pick up their stickers, their gift card to Baker's Pizza and Sports Shack, and a t-shirt just like this at the offices of Mizek Miller in Bucyrus and in Upper Sandusky. We will also be having a banquet for all the winners, and where we will decide a player of the year, which will receive this wonderful looking trophy from Dean's Trophy House on November 14th at Baker's Pizza and Sports Shack.
All right, that wraps up another week of High School Football Final. Be sure and stay tuned for next Wednesday's Week 7 of High School Football Final. You can find the video on the Facebook pages of Mizek Miller, Plymouth Insurance, WQEL and WBCO Radio, and Crawford County Now. We'll see you next week.
Good job, guys.
Let's get out of here.
All right.